गाइस, माय नेम इज दिव्यांशु एंड आई एम फ्रॉम बीटेक सीएससी ब्रांच इन वीआईटी चेन्नई। आई वाज रिसेंटली प्लेस्ड इन सोसाइटी जनरल एज अ सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियर विद अ पैकेज ऑफ 13.12 लाख। एप्लीकेशन एंड सिलेक्शन प्रोसेस इन सोसाइटी जनरल वाज प्रीटी स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू फिल अप अ फॉर्म and after that the people who were shortlisted for coding round were shortlisted on the basis of their initial CGPA. So I think that was around 8.5, and approximately 750 plus students were selected ahead for the coding round, and after that amongst that I think it was somewhere around 120 people who were selected for the interview process later. So the interview process which I went through, it had basically three rounds. The first two were technical rounds where there was a technical discussion with software engineers, which included coding and other stuff. And the last round was basically an HR discussion regarding whatever you have done in your 4 years of college. And the process was pretty easy, I would say. It's not that difficult. And the preparation that I went through for Society General, it was pretty normal, practicing coding, and especially dry coding is very important. And I also brushed through my fundamentals, the core CS fundamentals of my branches. So that was basically the preparation which I did for the interview process. So I think there is no single straight strategy for your placements. There are a lot of resources out there. There are a lot of things out there that you can go through when you're preparing for placements. There are various websites which even I used during my time. Two of them which I would especially like to mention would be LeetCode and Geek for Geeks. Both of these websites are really nice if you are trying to get into a software based company. They have CS fundamentals as well in them, so remember to go through them as well. And I think you can literally take any other resource that is available online, but it's important that you stick to a few so that you don't go haywire while preparing for your placements. The coding round in any interview process is very important, as it was for me. I was asked a variety of questions ranging from basic input output operations and even various sorting methods. So that is very important, when you are preparing for coding rounds, that you are well versed with your language and your code and be confident about it. I was also asked about React, just because I had some React experience in my resume. So be sure that whatever you're presenting in your resume, well, because it can be asked at any time. So, and it all depends on the interviewer and your resume, that what questions you can be asked. So be well prepared with everything that you have. I think it's really nice that you are in a technical or a non-technical club whenever you are entering in an interview. Because a club experience, it works wonders when you are in an interview, not just from the technical point of view, but also from an HR perspective, because there are a lot of things that can be asked about your college experience right there in the interview. So I think being in a club gives you that extra advantage, you have done something different in your 4 years of college other than just academics. So I think being in a club is really important, even for your resume and your interview in future. A perfect resume, in my opinion, is something which is having a perfect balance amongst your accomplishments, your skills, your background. And I think it's very important in your resume that you highlight the things that you are well versed in. Try to be concise, to be on point. I've seen many resumes with a whole lot of information. So try to be on point and concise. It should be sweet and simple and small as well. Also, if you have important projects, if you have a good work experience portfolio, that is gonna work in your favor whenever you are in interview always. because companies are looking for students that have done, you know, innovative projects or have some work experience, because that will, you know, lead to a lot of interaction with the interviewer, as he is also interested in how you implemented whatever you learned in your college. So I think it's very important to include your important projects and your work experience in your resume as well. That is the definition of a perfect resume. You know, whenever I was in college, many students, they are always overlooking soft skills as something, you know, which won't be ever used. But in my opinion, soft skills is really important whenever you are in an interview, because it's you just have a limited time with the interviewer and you have to put a good impression on him or her. And I think soft skills teaches us, you know, to how to present ourselves in front of people and how to convey them. I always say this, that it's very important, you know, as a person in an interview, that, you know, you might know that particular topic, but it's important how you convey it to them. So I think soft skills is really necessary whenever, you know, you are in an interview, and no one should overlook it at all. Yeah. The overall placement ratio of 2021 batch was really nice. I think most of us are placed right now, and you know, kudos goes to the PathCell for pulling something of this magnitude off. I think CGPA matters immensely whenever you are trying to apply for some companies, just for the initial shortlist. So whenever you fill out a form, there is always an initial shortlist after that regarding the CGPA. So like whoever has a higher CGPA, they have usually more opportunities, you know, to get placed in various companies. But I think you should not get demotivated if you don't have a particular CGPA, because there are a lot of opportunities for other people as well. You know, it always comes down to making the most out of it. So I think you shouldn't be demotivated if you don't have that perfect CGPA. But, you know, you just have to just dedicatedly work and hope that, you know, you cash in on the opportunity. So my personal advice to all my juniors would be that, you know, don't look into so many articles or, you know, read about how people got placed and their experiences. I mean, yeah, it's important to know about, you know, experiences of people. But in my opinion, it only makes you think more about what's gonna be wrong in future. So, you know, have a plan. Chalk out a plan well before. Stick to it. You know, dedication is really important. I think dedication and persistence are two major things that, you know, is important during placement scenarios. And, you know, just work hard, okay? And even if you don't get into your dream company, or you were planning to be in some company and you weren't able to crack that company, don't get demotivated due to that. There are a lot of opportunities out there. This is not the end of your professional life. This is just the start. So always remember that whenever you're giving or whenever you're preparing for placements, always remember that learning should be given the most priority, okay? And that, you know, this is just the start of your professional life and you have a whole life ahead. So work hard, you know, have a plan, okay? And be persistent, be dedicated towards your goal. And I think you'll easily crack it. There's nothing too difficult. It's very easy to crack, okay? So be happy and just keep on learning and keep working hard.